हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू वीडियो नंबर 1 ऑफ मॉड्यूल 4 दैट इज शेयर स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ द प्रीस्ट्रेस कंक्रीट सेक्शंस। शेयर रेजिस्टेंस विल बी कैलकुलेटेड एंड इट इज मैक्सिमम एट द सपोर्ट सेक्शन। वी नो दैट शेयर फोर्स विल बी मैक्सिमम एट द सपोर्ट सेक्शंस इन केस ऑफ सिंपली सपोर्टेड बीम। एंड शेयर डिस्ट्रीब्यूशन इज एन अनक्रैक्ड स्ट्रक्चरल कॉन्क्रीट मेंबर फॉर विच द डिफॉर्मेशन इज अज्यूम टू बी लीनियर। वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, इट इज linear and is a function of the shear force and the properties of the cross section members. Therefore shear stress depends upon the shear force at that section and the properties of the members. Therefore tau v is equal to vs divided by ib, where v is the shear force at the section and I is the moment of inertia, b is the width of the section and s is the statical moment of area or the first moment of area. That means if I take the one rectangular section and CG will be center, and if you consider only above the CG or below the CG, if I consider because it is same, it is symmetrical section and this is nothing but the area A, and from the CG of this hatched portion up to the common CG it is the x bar. Therefore A into x bar is the statical moment of area. The effect of shear stress is to induce the principal tensile stress on diagonal planes. We know that in case of RCC, the some bars will be bent at 45 degrees angles to take care of the diagonal tension created at that. That is the principal tensile stress, and it is at 45 degrees. It is maximum. We know that there are two planes. One is major principal and the one minor principal planes. And if we consider only the diagonal tension, which is created by the shear force. In case of pre-stress concrete members, the shear stress is generally accompanied by direct stress, that is in axial direction of the member. And if it is vertically pre-stressed, it is accompanied by the transverse pre-stressing. And if you consider one point at the support section, and Fx will be horizontal, Fy will be vertical, all Fx and Fy are compressive in nature, tau V is the tangential stress, and there will be cracks in this direction. To take care of this, bars will be bent here, but here it is not necessary to take that because a horizontal pre-stress is there, a certain extent it reduces the diagonal tension. And formula to calculate the F minimum, we are interested in the F minimum because F maximum will be always, if you take the plus sign of the top, minus for the F minimum. And therefore F maximum is equal to Fx plus Fy by 2 plus 1 by 2 root of Fx minus Fy bracket square plus 4 tau V square. For F minimum, we have to consider Fx plus Fy by 2 minus 1 by 2 root of Fx minus Fy bracket square plus 4 tau V square, where Fx and Fy direct stresses, tau is the shear stress at the tangential stress. Fx and Fy being compressive in nature, therefore the magnitude of the principal tensile stress is considerably reduced and in some cases even eliminated under the working loads. And major and minor principal are compressive, therefore by eliminating risk of diagonal tension in concrete members, completely we can eliminate. And generally we say that there are three ways or the three types we can reduce the diagonal tension in case of pre-stress concrete members. That is, one is by horizontal pre-stressing we can reduce the diagonal tension, and we can also reduce the diagonal tension by pre-stressing by inclined or the sloping cable steel. And this is also possible to reduce the diagonal tension or to completely eliminate by vertical pre-stressing. And the effect of these different techniques pre-stressing on the magnitude tensile stress by the following example. If you consider one problem and we can prove all the three, how it reduces the diagonal tension, the how much percentage reduces the diagonal tension with and without axial pre-stressing and with and without parabolic cables or the inclined cables or the vertical pre-stressing. Here is a problem, a pre-stress of span 8 meters and section being rectangular 120 mm wide, 250 mm deep is axially pre-stressed by a cable carrying an effective force of 150 kN. The beam supports a UDL of 4 kN which includes the self weight also. Then we have to compare the magnitude of the principal tension Here principal tension means it is F minimum in the beam with and without stress. The solution is we have to calculate the area and the moment of inertia and shear force at this section. It is 8 meter and 4 kilonewton meter is the load and 16 kilonewton simply supported and it's symmetrical loading. Shear force, therefore we can calculate by the WL by 2, 16 kilonewton is the shear force. And shear stress is calculated tau is equal to Vs by Ib. S is the statical moment, hatched portion area A, and then X bar is the Cg of the hatched portion from the common Cg. Therefore, S is equal to A into X bar, where A is the B into D by 2 and X bar is the D by 4 and total value is S is equal to Bd square by 8. And tau is equal to V, Bd square by 8 is S, Bd cube by 12 is I and the width of the section. If you simplify this, we will get the tau is equal to 3 by 2 V by Bd. This formula directly we can use wherever rectangular sections are there. In tau V, substituting all the values, we will get the value as 0.8 Newton per millimeter square. It is tau. And now we know the formula. Principal stress F maximum and F minimum is calculated. Case 1 without axial pre-stress. That means Fx is 0 and Fy is 0. No vertical and horizontal pre-stress. It is nothing but the RCC. Only tau is there, 0.8 Newton per millimeter square. Then substituting we will get the 0.8 Newton per millimeter square. And with axial pre-stress, the same member is horizontally pre-stress. Fx is equal to P by A. Then P is 150 kilonewton, section is 120 and 250. And if you substitute the values, you will get the 5 Newton per millimeter square. Then there is no vertical pre-stress, therefore Fy is 0. Fx, Fy and tau. Substituting all these three values, we will get the F maximum is equal to 5.125 and F minimum is minus 0.125 Newton per minute square, where with axial pre-stress. Just we can compare here. Without axial pre-stress, 0.8 was there. Here with axial pre-stress, it is almost reduced 0.125 Newton per millimeter square. That means here we can have the comparison and the percentage wise diagonal tension reduction will be 0.8 minus 0.125 divided 0.8, that is 84.37% we can reduce only by horizontal pre-stressing. Everything is same, only the member is pre-stressed by horizontal direction. And if you take the same problem, instead of axial pre-stressing with the bent cable or parabolic cable, here we consider the parabolic cable as maximum eccentricity is 75 mm at the center, 0 at the supports. Remaining values are same, P is equal to 150 kN, load is W 4 kN per meters. And estimate percentage of reduction in the principal tension in comparison with axial pre-stressing. Here we have to calculate first slope in case of parabolic cable, maximum eccentricity is 75 mm, 0 at the supports. And slope is 4 E by L. The value is 0.0375 radians. If you take the vertical component of inclined force, P is the inclined force, P cos theta is the horizontal force, and then P sin theta is the vertical pre-stress. Vertical component is, you can take 150 directly into theta, 0.0375, or you can convert this radians into degrees and then substitute sin theta values. Then you will get the same value, 5.625. And 5.625 will be downward and upward is 16 kilonewton. Net shear force will be 16 minus 5.625, that is equal to 10.375. This much has to take care of the by the members. That is, 5.625 will be take care by the inclined parabolic cable, and therefore the remaining will be on the concrete, that is 10.375. And taking the 10.375, you have to calculate what will be the tau V, that is shear V net value. Substituting these values, we will get the tau V is equal to 0.52. The previous tau was 0.8 without, that is axial pre-stressing. Then axial pre-stress is equal to Fx is P by A is remain same, 5 Newton per millimeter square. and fy is 0 here also, no vertical pre-stress. Substituting all these values in the same equation, f maximum is equal to 5.05 and the f minimum is important minus 0.055. That is how much it is reduced. Previously without axial pre-stress it was 0.8, with axial pre-stress it was 0.125, now it is only 0.055, almost it is, you can nil. Then how we can compare with the percentage wise, comparing the axial pre-stress percentage reduction in the tension. Axial pre-stress was 0.125 and minus 0.56%. The same member if you compare with without axial pre-stress, it is 84.3%. And as I told, if the same member is vertically pre-stressed, we can eliminate completely the diagonal tension. F minimum we can eliminate. Therefore, for that we can take the problem additionally. Pre-stress by vertical cables imparting 2 Newton per millimeter square, and the reduction of nature of principal stresses is support section. Fx is equal to 5, same member, because if it is force is also same pre-stressing, and it is additionally it is given vertical is, it is pre-stressed by 2 Newton per millimeter square. Tau is also same because loading is same, it is parabolic cable only and the loading is 4 kilonewton. Substituting all these three values you will get here f maximum is 5.0875, its important is, where f minimum is plus 1.9125. it is no negative, it is already is in the compressive nature, therefore we can eliminate completely stress, that is it is in the positive nature if it is vertically pre-stressed. Practically vertical pre-stressing is not so easy, it is a cumbersome, because vertical cables we have to fit, the depth of the section will be, losses will be also more because the depth is less, the length of the cable will be less, and already it is horizontally pre-stressed. But theoretically we can say that, or you can prove that we can completely eliminate the diagonal tension in the pre-stressed concrete members. Thank you very much. If you got any doubts, please contact me.